Hi, I'm Erica, and I'm here with another career connection from the Smithsonian's National Zoo and Conservation Biology Institute. Today, I'm at the Conservation Biology Institute in Front Royal, Virginia, where a lot of amazing science takes place. I'm about to meet Mel, a conservation biologist. As part of her unZOOsual career, Mel studies animals and acts like a spy to discover the secrets of protecting animals. Before we meet her, there are three things I can share about Mel and her career. First, she asks a lot of questions. Second, she uses technology to learn how animals move and answer those questions. And third, she creates maps for animal habitats to learn how the habitats change over time. Let's go meet Mel to get the inside scoop on her career.
I'm Mel, I'm a conservation biologist, and my job is about studying mammals that are endangered and sometimes even extinct in the wild to learn about what we can do to help them survive and thrive in the wild again. Conservation biology can mean many things, but one of the keys is that we are answering important questions about nature and then using what we learn to solve conservation challenges. I use advanced technologies to spy on the animals to try to learn about how the species are moving in their habitats. The Przewalski horses went extinct in the wild in the 1960s, and it's really only because of zoos and breeding centers like we have here that they survived. And through help from international organizations, governments, scientists, staff on the ground in China and Mongolia, they're actually now back in the wild. So here in Front Royal, we've worked on Przewalski horses for over 40 years, and more than 50 foals have been born here through research advancements. And so it's only through growing these healthy populations under human care that we get to the point where we can start to release them so they can return to the wild in China and Mongolia and other countries.
What tools do you use in your career?
I use a range of tools from very low-tech to very high-tech tools. For example, we can get a lot of information about animals from their poop. We can find out where they are, what they're eating. Sometimes, if we're lucky, we can even get their DNA. And I also use very high-tech tools like GPS, drones, infrared cameras, and tracking collars such as this, which we use for the horses. We can get their movements. So one of the really powerful tools we have is getting images of the Earth from satellites. So this is a picture of the Earth. And you can see this is habitat for Przewalski horses, and you can see the different types of habitat, and we can put their movements over this and see what they're selecting, where they're moving, how big a space they're moving in. So we can also layer different information like the roads, boundaries of the wildlife reserve, things like that. So by putting this all together in this GIS, which is computer mapping system, we can discover new things about their ecology that we can't see when we're just looking at the roads or just looking at the land cover.
What's something surprising that you've learned from studying wild animals?
Well, when I was in graduate school, we focused a lot on the things that people did that impacted the environment, that impacted animals, and then things that we could do to keep people away, keep people out of it. What I learned when I began my own research is that people that live near endangered species are an important part of the solution. We need to work together to find solutions that are in balance with people and with nature. So I discovered you really need people to save animals.
When did you become interested in this career?
One of my very earliest memories was when I was around 5 years old hiking in the Appalachian Mountains, and I remember I saw birds and a squirrel and even a deer, and I just couldn't believe that this was all there for free for anybody to explore. So I remember asking my mom, shouldn't we tell people about this? Because they're going to want to come out here and see it. And she said, I think they know. But after that, I just really grabbed any chances to be outside, whether it was hiking or camping, being outdoors in nature. And that eventually led to learning about nature, biology classes, and eventually graduate degrees.
What advice do you have for students who might be interested in this career?
I would say find something that inspires you and excites you and learn all you can about it. Learn about animals and what you can do to help them and their habitats. If you have a chance, talk to scientists and other people who are working in the field, learn about what they do, and that can help you figure out what you would be interested in doing. And also I would say just go outside, get out in nature, have fun, and learn about the world around you. The animals and habitats that are near you can be very exciting and inspiring.
Thank you so much for joining as we explored another unZOOsual career. I loved learning about the tools, maps, and technology that Mel uses in her career to conserve animals. You can practice being a conservation biologist just like Mel. Spend time in nature and ask questions about what you observe. Learn about the nature all around you and what you can do to protect animal habitats. I hope you liked meeting Mel as much as I did. She is certainly not horsing around when it comes to saving animals. Until next time.